Hello, all of my beautiful Euphoria fans out there. Did you miss me? So yeah, I finished watching episode 7. So in this video, we're gonna be talking about what was going on with Rue and kind of her manic and depressive episodes, as well as relationships, because we learned quite a bit about Cassie too. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, what I try to do is take different topics from movies, TV shows, the YouTube community, and try to see what lessons we can learn from them to improve our own mental and emotional well-being. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And for all of you people who have been subscribed, you know that I'm a little bit behind on the Euphoria breakdown videos. By the way, like, it warms my heart when you guys are like, oh, Chris, did you see the episode? I want you to break it down. So anyways, I didn't upload a video for 5 or 6, but I'm going to, so we're gonna backtrack a little bit later this week. But anyways, the reason why I didn't make videos on that is because I've been so busy lately writing my new book, which is out now and it's free, and it's called Canceled: Inside YouTube Cancel Culture. So please, 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 I put my heart and soul into this book, and I really hope it helps a lot of people out there, like, understand the problem with cancel culture. So check out the description, check out the pinned comment. It's up on my website. You can download it for free. It'd be amazing if you checked it out. So yeah, anyways, let's jump into episode 7, which revolved around Cassie, kind of. So although I'm gonna make a video recapping episode 6, in both these episodes, just kind of like real quick opinion, right? It's kind of interesting because, you know, each episode they kind of like focus on one character. And these last two episodes, they didn't do too much with that character, right? Like, you saw like the intro where they kind of built up their storyline. So anyways, we learned a little bit about Cassie and her relationship with her father. And I could definitely feel for her. And any of you out there who are the child of a drug addict or an alcoholic, like, you probably felt for her too, because we saw that Cassie's father turned into a drug addict. Here's something too, like, the situation that happened in the show with Cassie's father is extremely common, right? Like, where somebody goes to the hospital for an injury or a surgery and they get hooked on these narcotic pain medications. Like, I'm a recovering opioid addict, was 7 years clean. I just became addicted to those drugs because I wanted drugs, right? But I knew a lot of people who developed their addiction because they were given such strong medications while they were in the hospital. So this is something that happens way too often. So anyways, we learn more about Cassie, and I don't think what a lot of people are going to recognize is our relationships with our parents can kind of mold us and train us into who we fall for, right? So when you look at Cassie, like, I can definitely relate to it, right? But anyways, she's looking for a man, right? She's looking for a man who's gonna show her the love and attention that her dad did not show her, right? Because even before he became addicted to drugs, as soon as he left, like, he wasn't really in her life all that much, right? So she's looking for somebody. She's constantly looking for someone to be there. And, like, kind of like when Rue is narrating it and she discusses, like, how she does things, you know, sexually with her partners, like, letting them record it, like, even though she doesn't want to, she lets them. You know what I mean? So this is something that we all need to recognize about ourselves. Me personally, this is something that happened to me because my mother was an alcoholic until I was 20 years old. And I kept looking for love. I kept looking for broken women who I could try to fix. And I didn't know it until years later, and I was able to repair that behavior, but I was trying to find a woman I could fix because I could never fix my mom. One of the reasons that I was not comfortable being single and always needed somebody was there because I was never getting the love and affection from the woman in my life, but from my mom, right? So I was trying to use, you know, women, you know, in dating to be that person. You see what I mean? So I'm gonna link up in the info card right here if any of you wanna check it out. I made a video a long time ago called Why You Date Who You Date. All right, this is an exercise that I've done with a lot of people when I was working at the Addiction Treatment Center. It will help you understand why you keep picking the people that you keep picking, all right? So if you're somebody who notices that you keep going after the wrong type of person, like, make sure you check that video out. So next, let's talk about Rue, okay? So obviously in this episode, Rue is dealing with depression, but she's also dealing with manic states as well. They bring up bipolar disorder, even though she's not diagnosed with it and she starts, like, Googling stuff. So first, let's talk about that real quick. Don't do that, okay? See a damn doctor. Do not Google it. Especially when it comes to something like bipolar disorder. Bipolar disorder is so difficult to diagnose. For some people, it can take years to properly diagnose bipolar disorder. All right, so you're not gonna get your answers just by Googling it, okay? But anyways, I think, you know, the writers of this show, like when Rue was explaining depression and how like depression kind of starts getting rid of every joyful memory that you've had, and then eventually it gets to the point where you can't even remember a time when you weren't depressed. Like, yes, that is what depression does to you, okay? So the next things that I want to talk about is just how realistic is this? That's something I like to do too. Like, how realistic is what's happening in the show, okay? And I guess it could be realistic, but I'm just gonna let you know how typically like addiction treatment and addiction recovery works. So those of you who don't know, the addiction treatment center that I was working at for a little over 3 years, it was a dual diagnosis treatment facility, all right? So we specialize in addiction as well as mental health. Most addicts and alcoholics also have a mental illness. So when we look at Rue, if you remember back to episode one, she talks about how she was diagnosed with some various disorders like OCD, and I think she might've been diagnosed with bipolar at some point or another. So in the real world, we know that Rue went to rehab, and in the real world, at that rehab, they probably would have medicated her if she in fact had bipolar disorder, all right? There are many, many, many drug addicts and alcoholics out there who self-medicate because of their bipolar disorder, all right? So she would have received treatment for that in the drug rehab, but there also would have been an aftercare plan. So this is where I'm saying, like, it's kind of realistic, but kind of not, because before you leave treatment, they give you an aftercare plan, all right? They're like, listen, you got mental health issues, you're on medications, you're gonna need therapy, da-da-da-da-da, all these things. Here's what you're gonna do to continue your recovery, right? So a lot of times too, that's like go to 12-step meetings, which Rue is doing, but we haven't seen her follow up with a doctor, we haven't seen her follow up with a therapist. So I can tell you from my own experience, I've seen many people leave treatment and not follow through with their aftercare plan. So it's possible, I'm not sure if the writers meant to do that. It's possible that Rue did have an aftercare plan, but she just didn't follow through with it, all right? But that's something even more important that I wanna talk about. If you are a drug addict, okay, make sure you are following up with doctors, with therapists, and everything like that. Like, rehab is not the fix-all. Rehab is not an auto repair shop, okay? You don't just come in with a bzz, 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 fix you up. Like, it takes work and continuous effort to maintain our sobriety and our mental health. So follow up with your damn doctor, okay? But anyways, something even more important for all of you non-addicts out there, like through my previous videos, I know how many young people are watching this show. Listen to me very carefully, okay? If you start to have thoughts, feelings, emotions, kind of like we saw what was happening with Rue, like that are confusing or scary, please talk to an adult, okay? You should first talk to your parents, let them know what's going on. Like when I was growing up and I started experiencing symptoms of depression and anxiety, I get it, I was afraid to talk to them about it, but had I done that, I may have never become a drug addict because I would have gotten help, okay? So don't keep that to yourself. If you are worried about talking to your parents about it, find another adult that you can trust. Maybe it's an aunt or an uncle or an older sibling. Maybe it's somebody at school. Talk to a school counselor. Some people have school therapists or psychologists. At the time I'm recording this, it's summer vacation, right? But anyways, like during the school year, if this is happening, like even if it's not a counselor, like find your favorite teacher. Just please talk to an adult about this. No child should be battling this on their own, because we start to make really dumb decisions like, oh, I'm just gonna drink alcohol or use drugs to try to cope with this. And all it does is it starts to make your problems even worse, okay? So do not be afraid to talk to somebody and get help. The last thing that I'll talk about is something that Rue kind of explains in this episode, is that she loves the manic states, right? And this is something that a lot of people with bipolar disorder struggle with. They love the mania, but they hate the depression, right? But some people go untreated for their bipolar disorder because they don't want to lose that, all right? Kanye West is a great example of this. He stopped taking his medications and we know what happened with that. I think maybe just from an outside perspective, he might be back on them because he hasn't done anything, you know, too wacky in a while. But anyways, creative people especially don't like taking medications and treating their bipolar disorder because they feel even more creative when they're going through those manic states. But on the other end, like you saw with Rue, that depression is brutal, all right? So the higher the high means the lower the low, okay? Don't be afraid to at least give medications a try, all right? And continue to work with your doctor to find the right balance of medications. Don't ever think in a million years, and this is something I talk about in my book, Rewire Your Anxiety, don't think that because one medication didn't work well for you, that no medication will work well for you, okay? Like, we have to talk to our doctors, follow up, get adjustments, sometimes switch, and things like that, all right? Because you don't have to go through that depression the way Rue was going through, all right? There are things that can help, okay? But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this episode recap, and don't forget, please check out the description and the pinned comment down below. Go get your free copy of my brand new book, Canceled: Inside YouTube Cancel Culture. The audiobook will be out within the next week. After I upload this video, I'm gonna go back to recording the audiobook. Zach's editing it, all right? So make sure that you stay tuned, all right? Anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And a huge thank you to everybody who's downloaded the book already. And a big thank you to everybody who's helped donate to help me keep my lights on and pay my internet bill and keep making videos and writing books and all that stuff. All right, thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.